And coming in hot off the heels after last week's Skrillex inspired Serum 2 bass preset, which is this one right here. And as promised, I'll be diving into this little drop right here. Sharing my tips and tricks and what I picked up along the way to create this Skrillex inspired drop. Let's get into it. I think in the new era of Skrillex that we're witnessing, he tends to focus on two things, composition and the right sounds. So focusing in on sounds and placements is key, and that's what I tried to bring towards this drop. Quick breakdown of all the elements. Obviously, you got your main bass here. This is just a duplicate of that for the tutorial. And we've got like a reverse 808 here, providing the fill as well. Relatively simple bass, they're not overlapping, they give each other space. Stab sounds right at the start to provide a quick initial burst of energy. This was actually quite a long sample, but I just wanted that initial blap of sound in your ears. That is that, and then pitch down an octave for the second. A little bit of variation, a little bit more spice, I think it works a treat. A lot of this movement and groove in this drop comes from the bounce, in my opinion. Emphasis on the offbeat placements. So we have a downbeat placement like this, which is pretty quiet, taken from the stab sounds, but we also have, I'll turn the metronome on, and a bit more emphasis with vocal scratches. A lot of bounce to that, so if we just remove these two layers. Like it works, but I feel like with those two elements muted, it kind of works. It's like 80% there, but with the extra emphasized offbeat kind of duh placements, it's just, it really gets the head bopping. So yeah, that's a cool compositional thing to just take away from this video. The bounce. And while we're on the vocal channel, made up of a bunch of different layers, Skrillex definitely goes very hard with vocals these days. Throughout all his tracks, to be fair. I think he's quoted to say, like, the voice is one of the best instruments. It's so versatile and just so unique, and you can do so much with it.
The voice and mouth and, like, the whole, like, structure, your skull structure is like a synthesizer, like a organic synthesizer.
By combining, like, little vocal shouts and elements, like a cheeky, easy repetition, that's classic 140 kind of garage, just like a super simple hamdy on the beat, just repetition. Yep. Built up with some more vocal elements. This is quite a cool trick as well. Auto pan. A little bit more groove. I'll show you how to do that really quick. Auto pan, load that in. Amount, 100%. Naturally, this audio effect just defaults going left and right because it is a panning plugin, but you can do kind of like a tremolo effect if you turn the phase back down to zero, so. And we want to sync this to our tempo. Starting a little bit off so we can offset that. So the first initial is this ramp up instead of being ramped down. So a little bit more adding to the bounce and some DJ scratch sounds, etc., etc. Which wouldn't necessarily pick up just listening as is, but it all just blends. All these vocals just blend really nicely. And one thing you'll also notice, which I'll get into very shortly with the drums, everything is pretty much dry. There's no reverb, there's no delay. It's just, like I said, Skrillex is very focused on placements and the sounds of his tracks. Not too much reverb gets added these days. Which, I mean, this vocal verb kind of technically has reverb built into it, so we can honestly get rid of that. We wanted to completely get rid of the reverb kind of sound from the drop. Sounds a bit more tighter and cleaner. I feel like there's a bit of an irony of like using reverb and delay to help blend your sounds into your mix. But I feel like on the same page, if you don't use reverb or delay, your mix sounds tight and clean anyway, because the sounds are very direct and intentional. So yeah, bit of like a weird catch 22 or something. I don't know, maybe I'm just absolutely chatting shit. Anyway, speaking of drums, funky ass drums, no reverb whatsoever, completely dry. Love that snare sound. Took a few layers to get that right, like a stick layer, snare, and this little percussion sound. Beautiful. If you'll notice on these hi-hats right here real quick, they are super janky. Playing normal 16ths, it'll be like this. I've covered this on the channel so many times. I'm a massive fan of like swinging your hi-hats for like a groovier sound. So if we just loop this, normal, adds the groove, adds the sass. Easy way to do this is just on the grid hitting command 3, which changes everything to triplets mode, and then dragging the second a lot and the fourth a lot. You'll quickly hear how much groove you want with this, how much swing you want to add. So that's a little bit. That's way too much, maybe somewhere in the middle. You'll notice the sweet spot once you got it right for sure. They just add so much to the groove and flow. And lastly, kind of composition, kind of sound design, mix of the two. And that is like the moment of unsettlement right before the groove kicks in. If you think of this as our main groove, it's quite repetitive, the groove is very set, but this initial bit before it, kind of taken from trap, kind of teases you into it and then unleashes everything. It's a very trap thing for sure, but yeah, this initial moment of unsettlement is super, super key, with random sounds, DJ scratches, sub drops. Not everything's included in the drop, like the fast hats aren't in yet. So if I had this with the fast hats and with all the vocal stuff in, kind of just complicates it too much. We want minimalistic, not giving everything away, and then unleashing it all as soon as this kick drum kind of plays. So if you did want to check out the making of this main bass, that was last week's video. Full tutorial will be in the description, and I'll check it in the comments as well. And lastly, I'll be checking out this project file for free for the first 24 hours once this video goes live. Comments and description. So if you're quick, you can jump on this. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you learned a thing or two, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.